Hello everyone, we are starting with another paper of M1. This time it's the third variant of November 2012, and there are five questions which needs our attention in this particular paper. If I look at this question, this is question number one. The diagram will be on the next page. ABCD is a semicircular cross section in a vertical plane of the inner surface of half a hollow cylinder of radius 2.5 meter, which is fixed with its axis horizontal. Just look at this diagram. We have a shape. It's like a semicircle, ABC. So it's a cylinder half cut, and we are looking at the cross section. Now it says B is the lowest point, C is at a height of 1.8 meters, above the level of B, above the ground level. A particle P of mass 0.8 kg is released from rest at C and comes to instantaneous rest at C. Find the work done on P by the resistance to motion while P travels from A to C. That's the first part. The second part is the work done on P by the resistance to motion while P travels from A to B is 0.6 times the work done while P travels from A to C, because the distance AC is much bigger as compared to AB. Therefore, the work done from A to B is 0.6, the answer of part one. Find the speed of P when it passes through B. Now, let's look at the question. Total energy at A, that's potential at A, kinetic at A. Kinetic at A is zero. Potential at A is mgh. Similarly, total energy at C is potential at C, kinetic at C. Again, kinetic at C is zero. The difference between the two total energies is the work done against resistance. So take common and simplify. You find the work done against resistance. Now, for the second part, work done from A to B against resistance is 0.6 multiplied by 5.6. After multiplication, that comes out to be 3.36. Therefore, total energy at A, that's 0.8 into 10 into 2.5. Total energy at B, what do you think will be the potential at B? The potential energy at B would be the zero, because for this diagram, B is like the base level. B is the ground level. Height is zero. The difference between total energy at A and total energy at B is work done against resistance, which is 3.36. Use your calculator and then you get the answer. So that was the first part. The paragraph was very long. The diagram was pretty simple. As long as you remember the basic rules of conservation of energy, if there is no work against resistance, total energy at A equals total energy at B. If there is work involved, then there are four cases. Remember those four cases. They were about horizontal surface. They were about vertical movement. They were about an inclined plane. And they were about vehicles with an engine or particles being pulled by an external force. Question number two. A particle moves in a straight line. Velocity is given by such and such. For the instant when the acceleration of the particle is 2.5 times its initial acceleration, show that the time is 25. That means at 25 seconds, the initial acceleration, the acceleration of the particle is 2.5 times its initial acceleration. Find the displacement of the particle from O. First, differentiate velocity expression. You get an expression for acceleration. It's a simple differentiation. Initial means time t is equals to zero. Therefore, A comes out to be 0.2. Therefore, take your acceleration equation in terms of t and equate it to 2.5 multiplied by 0.2. Solve, you will definitely get the value of t is 25. Now, in order to find the displacement equation, Read the question again, the second line. Its velocity t seconds after leaving a fixed point O, that means initially it was at O and we are measuring the distance with respect to O. That means what is the initial condition? The initial condition is when t is 0, s is 0. Displacement equation is obtained by integrating the velocity equation. Never ever forget the constant of integration. Plug in the initial conditions. You find the value of C. Hence, this is your displacement equation. Simply plug in the value of T is equals to 25 and you will find the displacement equation. And the answer comes out to be 93.75 meter. There is no need of rounding off because the examiner is asking us to round off if the answer is inexact. If the answer is exact, doesn't make a difference what is the level of accuracy to which the exact answer is written. If it came out to be 93, we would write it as 93. If it comes out to be 93.755, we would simply write 93.755. In this case, it's 93.75. So question 2 is also done. Question 3, straightforward. Question 4, straightforward. Question 5, let's see. An object of mass 12 kg slides down a line of greatest slope of a smooth plane inclined at 10 degrees. Object passes through A and B with speeds 3 and 7. Now, in this particular question, remember, it says the word respectively. So first it's passing through A and then passing through B. That means A is higher up the plane and B is a bit down the plane. Of course, common sense also tells you that as the particle is going to move down the plane, the velocity would increase. So definitely A is higher up the plane as compared to B. Find the increase in kinetic energy. Find the distance AB, assuming there is no resisting force acting on the object. So first one is simple, half mv square minus half mu square. Second one is about the principle of conservation of energy. And then it says the object is now pushed up the plane. We'll see that in a short while. So the first part, change in kinetic, half into 12 into 7 square minus 3 square. That comes out to be 240 joules. Method 1 for doing part 2, change in kinetic is change in potential. Change in kinetic is already known. Change in potential would be mgh or mg sine theta into distance along the plane. That distance comes out to be 11.5. What do you think is method 2? Method 2 is what we use the most. Total energy at the top minus total energy at the bottom, that is equals to work done against resistance. But there is no work done against resistance. It's simple principle of conservation. So total energy at A equals to total energy at B. Therefore, half into 12 into 3 square plus 12 mg sine theta. Kinetic energy at B is half into 12 into 7 square. And you make D the subject of the equation. That comes out to be 11.5 meters. So there were two ways of doing it. Both are about the principle of conservation of energy. This one as well as this one. They both are about principle of conservation of energy. But there are two different approaches to solve that particular question. Let's look at the third part. The object is now pushed up the plane from B to A with a constant speed by a horizontal force. Now remember one thing. Whenever the word horizontal is there, it means parallel to the x-axis. So horizontal is like this. That means if I have a force which is horizontal to the inclined plane, there are two components involved. A red component and a black component. If this angle is theta, if this force is F, this would be F cos theta because this angle is theta. And definitely this one would be F sine theta. Remember, adjacent goes with the word, with the trigonometric ratio cos. So adjacent is linked to cos. Therefore, the other one has to be sine. This theta for this angle theta, this is the adjacent side. So that is why this one is f cos theta, the other one is f sine theta. And of course, you have learned this thing in great detail. Now, let's come back to the question. We are pushing it up. It's a smooth plane, constant speed. So therefore, change in kinetic and change in potential should be 240, just like before. Top to bottom, bottom to top. But this time, there is work done. So do not confuse the two. This time what is happening is that in order to push it up, in order to make it move against gravity, you have to do work. But since you are traveling at a constant speed, work done on that object equals to change in potential. So the work done is due to this force F. Which component is going to do the work? F cos theta. So F cos theta multiplied by the distance along the plane, which we found in the previous part as 11.5, that is equals to change in potential, and change in potential and change in kinetic is the same. So this was slightly tricky. Smooth, yes, there is no work done against resistance, but no one is stopping you from applying a force on that particular object in order to make it move up. So this was slightly tricky question. Okay, Jay, let's move on. Question number 6. It says the diagram shows a particle of mass 0.6 kg inclined at 25 degrees. Particle is acted on by a force of P Newton directed up the plane to a line of greatest slope. Coefficient of friction is 0.36. Given that the particle is in equilibrium, find the set of possible values of P. Now, remember that in friction, when you are applying an external force, there is a tendency in equilibrium, and this particular equilibrium is called what? Do you remember the term? It's called limiting equilibrium. There are two possibilities. Either the particle is going to slide up or the particle is going to slide down. If it's going to slide up, friction is down. If it's going to slide down, friction is up. Let's look at the working. Forces everywhere. Label it correctly. The external force needs no resolution. It's about to slide up. That is the first case, the first scenario. Mg sine theta, Mg cos theta, normal reaction force. These three are the first to be labeled. And then depending upon the scenario, you would label F max. So in this case, I've labeled F max as down because I'm dealing with the scenario that the particle is going to move up. So therefore, R is equals to 0.6 g cos 25. And F max is mu R. That's mu into 0.6 g cos 25. And we are finding the value of mu. Therefore, upward force is equals to the weight component plus the frictional force. Say it in words, then write it down, then involve the variables. Think in words. Think in English, write in math. So therefore, P comes out to be this value. This first scenario is done. Have a look. Now, if we move to the next case, it's about to slide down. Therefore, friction is up. Everything else is the same. R is still a normal reaction force. Mg cos theta is in the opposite direction of R. Mg sine theta is down the plane, but F max is up. So therefore, R would still be the same. I simply copy pasted from the previous page. R is this much, F max is mu R, mu Mg cos theta. We know the value of mu. P plus F max is equals to Mg sine theta. What does it mean? The upward force along the plane, the external force acting along the plane upwards, plus the frictional force, they both equal the weight component. Make P the subject. Use a calculator. And then you find the value of P. Use the calculator once. Plug in everything in the calculator. Therefore, the set of possible values of P. There are two ways to write this answer. One answer is the greatest value, the maximum value. The other answer is the least value, the minimum value. So P max was on the previous page. P min was on this page. these are the two possible scenarios. Some people, some examiners, they want to write it as an inequality. Feel free to write so. So therefore, in the inequality format, P lies between 4.49 and 0.578. Both answers are correct to three significant figures. Let's move to the very last question. And that is about this diagram. Another question of a connected particle. One particle is on the table. This time it's a smooth table. The other particle is hanging freely. A is 0.98 meters above the ground. Think what the examiner is going to ask. A hits the ground, does not rebound, string becomes slack. Particle B is behaving as a free particle. It's approaching the pulley. With what speed would A hit the ground? With what speed will B hit the pulley? And in this particular question, it's about a smooth table. Remember that in class, we also talked about a rough table. And of course, there are questions in the exams which are about a rough table. So now let's read the question. The question says, particles A and B have the following masses. Everything else is there. Find the acceleration. Find the tension. A hits the floor. B continues to move towards the pulley. Find the time taken from the instant that B is released for A to reach the floor, B to reach the pulley. Now let's look at the working. Mg sine theta minus tension, my bad, it's not an inclined plane. Sometimes you visualize more than what is actually in the reality. Mg minus tension is mass into acceleration. Second equation, tension minus nothing. Tension minus nothing because it's a smooth plane. The weight of particle B is acting vertically down. The tension is pulling it to the right. They have no connection whatsoever. Tension minus nothing is mass into acceleration. Add both the equation. And what you get is the acceleration of the system. That acceleration of the system of the connected particle is coming out to be 4 meter per second square. Tension, you can find using the second equation, which is very easy to use. What's the other thing? Find the time taken for the particle to reach the ground. V is equals to u plus at. Simple equation. Some people, they prefer s is equals to ut plus half at square. I personally prefer v square is u square plus 2as. And hence you find the value of v. That comes out to be 2.8 meter per second. Now, particle B has moved forward a distance of 2.8 meters. What else am I calculating? I'm calculating the time. That is 0.7 seconds. Actually, it was not asking for the velocity. It was asking for the time. So instead of using s is equals to ut plus half at square, I just have this tendency of first using v square and then v is equals to u plus at. Now, particle B has moved ahead 0.98 meters. Therefore, the distance before the pulley, the distance left to be covered, that comes out to be 0.42 meters. Now, nothing is going to slow down particle B because it's a smooth plane. It's moving at a constant speed of 2.8 meter per second. The final speed just before A hits the ground, that becomes the initial speed of particle B, and it will remain constant throughout because it's a smooth plane. So 2.8 meter per second, that needs to be, that should be the speed in order to cover 0.42 meter. That comes out to be 0.15 seconds. That means the total time taken for particle B is 0.7 plus 0.15, which is 0.85 seconds. This is the time taken for particle B to hit the pulley. So it was a simple but elegant question. That finishes all the three variants, the important questions on all the three variants of November 2012. Take care.